Hello guys, what's up? As I promised you in the previous video, where I unboxed the Galaxy Book 5 Pro 360 to evaluate its performance and try some things out. So here we are. In this video, I will be disabling CPU boost, which I did before for the Galaxy Book 4 Ultra and the Pro 360. And they both benefited quite a lot, reducing temperatures, saving more power without a lot of performance trade-off. And it also eliminated Windows stuttering and gaming lag that they suffered due to thermal throttling. Now this time, we have a different chip. Galaxy Book 5 family comes with Intel latest solution for ultra-mobile notebooks, Lunar Lake, which promise better efficiency than last year Meteor Lake found in the Galaxy Book 4 notebooks. However, I still wanted to try this sample tweak to see the outcome. So I hope you will join me in learning more about it and how to apply it. So let's get to it. First in Windows, go to Start menu and type Registry Editor. Then open the editor as admin. Here on the navigation bar, just paste the directory address that I included in the pinned comment of this video. To make it easier, you will find a key called Attribute, which by default is set to 1. Double click on it and then change its value from 1 to 2. Press OK. Then again in the Start menu, type Edit Power Plan and go to Power Settings. Then make sure your current power plan is set to Samsung mode. And go to Change Plan Settings, then Change Advanced Power Settings. Under Processor Power Management, you will find this new option that is hidden by default, known as Processor Performance Boost Mode. You will see it set to Aggressive by default in both battery and plugged-in states. There are some options too, but they all allow CPU boosting frequency, which is 4.8 GHz for this CPU 256V, while the base clock is 2.2 GHz, which by the way is around the same as Meteor Lake 2.3 GHz for P cores, and while it's 1.8 for E cores. But the difference is that Lunar Lake has a fewer core count and a more advanced node, so it should deliver similar or higher performance while being more efficient. And that's what makes this comparison actually interesting. So anyway, set the option to disabled for both battery and plugged in. But that will be also up to you. Like for example, if you want to make it to boost when plugged in and not do while on battery to save more power. We'll see in a bit the results of power consumption difference. So we will test it in 4 power profiles by Samsung: silent, which has lowest fan noise and lowest power limit. With the quiet, it's higher but still less noisy. Optimized, which is balanced, and finally performance, giving us the highest performance possible with loudest fans noise. We ran Cinebench R23 benchmark in both multi and single core, comparing CPU boost on versus off for all these 4 profiles. And here are the results. For multi-core, we can see for silent with boost off, we got around 6136, with boost on 7185, so around 1000 less. With the quiet mode, 6111, and with boost on 9003. So this time it's around 3000 points difference. Then in optimized, it's again similar at 6110 with boost off versus now 9764 with boost on. So over 3500 points. And finally with performance mode, it's still at 6104 with boost off versus 10258 with boost on. So roughly up to 4000 difference if you choose to turn off turbo clock. While for single core workload, we got around 830 to 40 with boost off, while 1301 with silent, 1808 with quiet, 1878 with optimized, and finally 1856 with performance. So up to 1000 more points in single core. But no matter how you look at it, it's still impressive. If you see with Meteor Lake running on the Galaxy Book 4 Pro 360, it got with boosting on up to 11630 multi-core and 1745 single core with performance profile. But at the cost of extremely high temperature and high power consumption, which for example reached 54 watts and in consequence showed performance inconsistency. In test from the first loop, where it's cooler versus to the last one, as you can see, so it wasn't steady at all in terms of performance. While with Galaxy Book 5 Pro 360 and its lunar lake, it's a different story. It never showed any thermal throttling indication with boost on. Still, let's have a look at this chart to spot some difference. Here we have those 8 setups with all 4 profiles and CPU boost on and off. The first thing we will all notice is that our core voltage in all boost off setups is 0.753 volt, which is extremely low. Our highest clock is 2.2 GHz, while with boost on, our max voltage is 1.078 volt, which is still pretty more efficient than Meteor Lake, with highest clock ranging from 4700 to 4800 MHz. But here is where we will start to see more difference in CPU temps: 63 degrees in silent boost off, while 89 degrees with boost on. Then even lower at 55 degrees with quiet and boost off, given that fans spin faster in a quiet profile than in silent. So we have 55 degrees recorded max temp, while on the other part, 89 degrees with boost on. Then in optimized profile, it's the same 55 degrees with boost off versus 86 degrees with boost on. And finally again, 55 degrees with boost off and 89 degrees with boost on. So the difference in temps can be up to 35 degrees Celsius, which is quite notable and significant. It also seems that 89 degrees is the max temp that the CPU is designed to reach, so it avoids thermal throttle. It's good that Intel came to address the uncontrolled temperature we used to have on Meteor Lake last year. As for our power limits, PL1 and PL2, they didn't change at all, since we didn't tweak them. They are at 15 watt and 37 watt respectively. However, our achieved max power consumption has been reduced by turning off CPU boost. It's 13 watt with silent, jumping by over 16 to reach 29 watt with boost on. Then in quiet, it still remained 13 watt, but got even higher to 37 watt with boost on. Again, same with optimized and performance. So you can see our power consumption has been reduced by up to 24 watt, which is quite impressive given that the performance trade-off wasn't even by one time higher. With CPU boost off, this way we would extend battery life by around 2 times while still have modern great performance experience for a mobile notebook. And let's not forget exterior temps, which are crucial for having a nice experience on a notebook. So you can see with silent mode, our highest temp where chip is located is 33.5 degrees while 42 with boost on. 33.6 with quiet mode plus boost off, and 44.7 with boost on. With optimized, given the faster fan speed, CPU boost only closed the gap, hitting only 2 degrees higher temp than when we have CPU boost disabled. Finally, in performance mode, it's 35.5 degrees with boost off versus 42.5 degrees, so around 7 degrees higher, which makes the experience still feel different. Now, how about in gaming? Here we are in Cyberpunk 2077 in 1080p, native resolution at low settings. We can see that our CPU power use has dropped in silent mode by having boost off, while also dropping FPS compared to boost on, still with lower temps by 10 degrees for both CPU and GPU units. While in quiet mode, it closed the performance gap, given that now GPU has higher clock, which is more crucial in gaming. So now it's getting same FPS with boost off versus on, and all the same in optimized and performance profiles, they are all around 40 FPS, whether you have boost on or off, because we didn't limit the GPU clock there. We just worked on CPU frequency. So it's still boosting to 1950 MHz, which is a max frequency for 256V chip using ARC 140V iGPU. But nonetheless, our temps have definitely dropped with boost off. Like you can see, 68 compared to 75, 67 to 77, and 67 to 77 again. Power draw lowered by around 7 watt in gaming in this instance. Also, looking at Cyberpunk benchmark final scores, only with silent plus boost off setup, it got 17 average FPS, that is lower compared to CPU boost on. But from a quiet, optimized to performance, it's the exact same score, while still having lower temps by around 7 degrees and saving extra 7 watt too. So you don't really benefit from CPU boosting clock in almost all gaming purposes in this kind of hardware. So guys, at the end, my idea of doing this T-Week will be applicable in situations when you want to focus on extending battery life and lowering temps from inside and outside. And of course, whenever you need it to boost, you can always turn it on with the press of a button. So I hope this video was useful for you to know about it and what to expect out of disabling CPU boost. So if it was useful, please give this video a like and subscribe to TechoSword to support me and be updated for different things we will try on the Galaxy Book 5 Pro 360 from now on. Also, if you have any question or something that you would like me to try on, please leave it in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.